What's up, my reptile loving people? My Lord, look at this beauty. You know, I just keep seeing it, right? How, when, can I, should I get a snake, okay? The problem is that I feel like a lot of people don't do their research. You gotta do your research if you're looking to get any snake. I don't care what you think it looks like when you see it at the pet store or at one of these little reptile exhibits or shows or whatever it is you come across, as I'm trying to scream over all the kids running around my yard. I've seen a ton of questions coming up asking, you know, about, you know, should I get an anaconda, a reticulated python, a Burmese python? Three of not only the largest snakes that you could possibly own, but three of the largest snakes on our planet. I would love, let me tell you. I'm that guy, I think you guys have realized it. I would love nothing more to have one of those large boys in my house, but the problem is I don't have a room big enough for an adult-sized swimming pool, let alone the rest of the enclosure that isn't water, for one of those snakes. And I just don't. I hear a lot of it though that, you know, they're super expensive and you better have this, and you better have that. You know, this dude right here is eating three times a week just so that I make sure I don't overfeed him. So as they get bigger, but the problem is they're gonna grow fast and they are gonna eat some big expensive meals no matter how often you're feeding them or not. This guy here, for example, right? My beautiful BCI or Redtail, AKA Boa, whatever you wanna call it, it doesn't matter. The point of these guys are is that they're huge in the reptile trade. Huge, huge, huge. Yes, there are some beautiful morphs that come along with these guys. The problem is that when you go to the pet store, they're about that big, right there, right? If you look from right here to the top of his head that he's gonna like me touching, to right there, you're looking at about a 2-foot snake. You see it, it's for $99, $200, God, $40, whatever it is. And then before you know it, you end up with literally the large 5, 7, 10, sometimes even 12-foot snake. look, y'all should know me by now, my bad. I meant we feed him once every 3 weeks. My wife was like, what did you just say? Three times a week? No. Once every 3 weeks, this dude is getting a large rat. My bad. Look, that's what happens when you're just on the whim. But I'm here to show you guys and tell you guys, these guys right here, in my opinion, are the single most beautiful, awesome snake you could ever own. They do get big, but the problem the thing about them though is that they get just big enough to where one person can manage them. Now, yes, a 12-foot snake I would not recommend somebody handling, but that is rare and usually it's a female. Females get a lot larger than these guys. But they are beautiful. And yes, there's all these new things about the BCI and the BCC, and I don't know how new it is or not. It doesn't really matter to me, I don't care. My point is that regardless, they're all the same. These boas are phenomenal. They're great, they actually lay live babies, and sometimes they can have about 32 babies if you do decide to breed them. You will basically see these guys everywhere you go, from every pet store to every reptile show. And for the most part, these are the ones that I've kept the most. I've maybe had one out of, I don't know, maybe 10 that is just a butthead and you can't handle. But I wanted to share you guys. The number one thing, it doesn't matter who you are, what you are, if your first snake, your 100th snake, you should always be doing your research. And with Google and Facebook and Instagram and all of these pages and social media platforms that you can get on and do some research and ask some questions, do it. And my God, I am sorry that the reptile community is a bunch of buttheads. No offense if it's you, but ask the question. But you might get that one, especially if I see it, that makes you realize or feel, should I or should I not get a specific snake? Like I say, these dudes right here, what you doing, my dog? Awesome right here, man. And you know what else it does? It keeps all the neighborhood kids from coming around. Yeah, I know you hear them in the background, but they ain't coming over here. You know why? Because I'll feed them to my dog, DJ. Is he heavy? Tell him, Colton, what do you think about this snake? You gotta be loud.
I love him.
You love him? Here's the other thing. I have two kids. I have another one on the way. And even though these snakes do get big and they do their thing, I would trust my kids with them. Right, Colton? What do you think?
Because we love snakes.
So remember that. I got a video coming soon. Remember, the fear of snakes is taught at home.
I will say that about 9 out of 10 times, and I know some other things and the reasons why, and I got some more of that coming. But remember that my kids right here love snakes. Why? Because they're around them all the time, and they've learned to respect them, not love them. I hope you guys enjoyed this short clip. All the neighborhood kids that you can't see, because I told them they can't be on YouTube unless I know. But here we are with our boy, DJ, the BCI Redtail Boa. And I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Tell them what they should do.
Smash that subscribe button,
guys, and we'll see you next time. See ya. Salute them.